Hi guys, so today I'm going to talk about some bad makeup habits that we all have done at some point and we need to stop doing them right now. So I will be doing all of the mistakes on this side of my face and will do them on the correct way on this side. So let's start with the priming thing. So what we usually do is just take the foundation, directly apply it on the skin and then just start blending it, which leads to dry patches, uneven skin and even cakey foundation. So priming is one of the most essential steps for a flawless base and you should never skip on that. And what exactly does priming involve? Priming means preparing your skin before putting on any base product. So I recommend that you also exfoliate your skin if you have dead skin cells. So another important thing is moisturizing your face well to avoid the dry patches if you have dry skin like I do. Now, if you also have pores, I recommend using a nice primer before your makeup, just like I do. I like to use the Benefit Professional Primer. This one really helps to give a flawless base and also helps to hide pores on the skin and some imperfections too. So priming is a great thing before starting on with your makeup. So I have already cleansed up my entire face and now I am moisturizing only half of the face so that you can see the clear difference. I'm just using a normal biotic moisturizer, nothing too fancy. Now I am using my primer above it. Just spreading it with my hand. Can you see the difference by just priming half of my face? You can also leave it like this if you do not want to put on any foundation. I can literally feel how smooth this side is. So basically, I have prepared my face for a nice base. Now, the second thing that I'm going to talk about is the application part. For the people who use beauty blenders or sponges to blend the foundation, it's very important to know how to use them. Now, what they normally do is, just take a foundation and use a dry beauty blender over it. Whereas you should always damp up the beauty blender and then blend your foundation with it. A dry beauty blender is going to absorb all of the product and nothing is actually going on your face. So a beauty blender should always be damp and then used to apply the foundation. So I will be using it dry on this side of the face and then we will see the difference. So let me just put on some foundation. This is the Bobbi Brown Stick Foundation. And what I've seen people doing is just dragging the beauty blender like this. Doing it like this. Now trust me, this is not going to help at all. Rather, what you should do is, you should always push the product in and tap the beauty blender like this. So here I am, applied my foundation with barely anything gone on my face and it's not flawless at all. I will show you the close-up too. Now let's dip it in water and see the magic.
So let's just dip it in water and just squeeze out the excess water. The beauty blender will enlarge a little bit after you squeeze all the water from it and it will become even more softer and will not absorb more product.
Now let's use a damp beauty blender on this side of the face and see the difference. Let me just apply the same foundation all over the face. I mean half of the face. Now with the damp beauty blender, what I'll do is I'll just push the product in. Rather than, you know, dragging it all around. See the natural glow on this side, which is not present here. Same product, but just a different technique on this side and a different way of application. Trust me, it makes all the difference. So the third thing that I'm going to talk about is picking the right color of foundation. Now, as we belong from the fair and lovely nation, so women in India tend to pick a foundation that is lighter than their original skin tone to look more fairer, which leads us looking more ashy, uneven, and definitely unnatural. It can also make you look like a ghost. Trust me, I have seen people wearing a different shade of foundation and it does not look good at all. So I'll show you what a lighter shade of foundation does to your face. Now this foundation is approximately two to three times lighter than my original skin tone. Let's see how it makes me look like. Let's drag it, do it all wrong. Now it's a little bit of the cheating because my beauty blender is wet, it's not dry, but it's okay. Anyways, this side is not going to look good. Ashy, unnatural, and definitely not me. This differentiates me from my entire body. And this side looks like me, like I'm not wearing any makeup and I'm actually so beautiful. This is like the no makeup makeup kind of look, whereas this one is. So you should choose the right shade. That's very important because we should really start embracing our original skin color. Another huge mistake is not doing the powder. Now, even if I have dry skin, yet the foundation tends to sit at some places like the under eyes, the corner of the mouth. So it's very important to powder these areas. Otherwise, the foundation will wrinkle in those areas. Like we smile, it just collects in this area and forms wrinkles, which definitely does not look good. And if you possess oily skin, I would recommend that you powder your whole face nicely. It will not only save you from a wrinkle-free face, but also help stay your foundation in place for longer. And by nicely, I don't mean like, yes, I've done the powder. No, you have to take a good amount of powder, cover your entire face with it. Apply it generously and then remove it in a moment. Just like the baking process. That's what even our beauty guru Huda Kittan has to say about baking. Apply it, let it sit on your face for a while and then just dust off all the powder. This is a great tip for making your foundation stay in place for longer. I love this side. This looks so smooth and so beautiful. And I hate this one. So guys, those are the things that I have experienced and seen people doing them. So I wanted to share them with you. Avoiding this will definitely improve your makeup and look flawless, like the no makeup makeup thing. Now let's see the close-ups of both the sides. This is the bad side, which did not turn out to be flawless because I did not powder properly, so foundation settled under my eyes. And that's clearly visible, which is not good. And then my face looks patchy because of the dryness and the fact that it was not prepped properly before putting the foundation on.
The camera, of course, did not do justice to it because in real, I could easily notice the patches.
I hope you found it informative. So don't forget to subscribe.